Welcome back to Wasteland 2. We are currently on the road to the prison, and we just cleared out this large area here. Now it's time to keep moving west and hopefully find the actual prison. Gotta keep on the lookout for mines too, because I just disarmed like a dozen. This enemy's that way, so what's over this way? What is this area here? Is there some way to get there? I guess not. That was weird. This little extra path over here felt like it was super special, and then it's just free shotgun ammo. I was thinking maybe there'd be an alarm or something, but nope. Alright, how do I approach this? Bunch of people. There's a bit of cover. I wonder if I can take cover behind the cacti. It's Cactus Henge. Huh? What is? I don't see no Cactus Henge. Well, because I just start shooting. Hopefully I can use a cactus for cover. God. You may be wondering what I just did there. I just discovered something. See, what I had intended to do was select everybody, deselect Takayuki, and then have them crouch, because Takayuki's melee, so I don't actually want him to crouch, because he needs to be mobile. And to do that, I used the standard kind of Windows thing, right, where you like select all the icons, hold down Control, and then click on whatever you want to deselect. However, if you hold down Control and click on somebody, everybody shoots them, as I just discovered. So that's what just happened. I'm gonna reload my game now. I did not intend to have everybody shoot up Takayuki. Let's try it again. Let's not hold Control. Does Alt work? Is that a yes? Actually, do you even need to hold anything? Or what? I don't even. What just happened? No, that didn't work. I don't know. Fine. Nobody's gonna crouch. Fuck it. I don't even care anymore. Okay, I'll make them crouch. There's gotta be a way to just deselect someone. No, like, no, don't. Oh, alright, whatever. No! You son of a bitch. Ooh. Shotgun blast to the face? No. Because I don't think Yulia's Overwatch is triggered yet. Yeah. What the hell? What the hell was that sound? Let's not burst fire. Don't need that anymore. Let's kill you. And you. Yeah, it's probably worth a burst fire. Jesus. She shot off his arms. I suppose we can blow up his cover. Or blow up my cover. Boxes explode. Sandbags do not. Let's see if I can scare him out of there. 49%? Eh, it's not worth it. Can I get better? 59? Eh, it's still not worth it. Yes, I scared him away. Some height advantage up here. He's probably gonna be dead before she has another turn, but let's do it anyway. Cover our bases. Oh no, this cover is actually still valid, despite being exploded. Force him to keep moving. See if we can get him to panic. Slice him up. Yeah, slice him up good. And we have a level up.
Copy, Echo. Congratulations, Jesse.
Save for skill points. 5 skill points, nice. Need 6 to upgrade these. Maybe I should just save it. I don't feel like I need more Animal Whisper. I've rarely used it. Yeah, I'm just gonna save for points. Put into Sniper or Safecracking next. Getting so much ammo and weapons from these people, my god. Oh, whoa, I just picked up, hold on. I just picked up something. Other than a weapon. This. Anger management for angry managers, what? What is this? Congratulations, reader. What you hold in your hands will not just solve your problems, but the problems of all people around you. Well, that's right. Stop and think about it. Look to your left. Now look to your right. Who close to you have you not hurt with your anger? Now go to a mirror and look into it. Really look, because no matter what, no one's been hurt by you more than you. But this book has your answers. Do try this at home. How do I know I'm an angry manager? Shout at an employee at least once a day? Never allow anyone an extra second in their lunch break? Fire more people than you hire? Have a hard time compromising? Notice people go real quiet when you walk into the room? Scrawled in the margin. Sick your dogs on your men? You may very well be an angry manager. So what should I do? First and foremost, pay attention to the signs of anger as they appear. Knots in stomach, clenching hands, seeing red, tensing up of the body. These are all warning signs that may come well before your anger actually expresses itself. This is the time to stop yourself before your anger affects others and yourself. So, how to help yourself help others? Here are our top 10 tips for anger management. Think before you speak. What are you about to say, and how will it affect people around you? Give yourself a few seconds to figure this out. Number 2, get some exercise. A brisk walk around the block or a quick run will do wonders for your equanimity. Number 3, take a time out. It's not just for kids. Put yourself in the corner for a while. Number 4, focus on the physical sensation of anger. Focus on the way it's making you feel, and this will actually put your mind at... It'll put your mind at east. Yes, put your mind at east, never west. Number 5, stretch, roll, or massage physical points of tension, especially after doing number 4. Number 6, dance to the music. Put on your favorite jams and just move the anger away. Number 7, use humor to release tension. The right joke at the right time helps cool everybody down. Scrolled in the margin. Avoid your mama jokes from now on. Number 8, punch a pillow. Relieve your anger on an inanimate object in private. Scrolled in the margin. Shooting it also works. Number 9, stick with I statements. Beginning with yourself before talking about others will help stop you from purely blaming others for problems that may well be yours. Number 10, count to 10. And there you go, it's really that simple. With these 10 easy tips, you are guaranteed, asterisk, to never have issues with anger again. You'll find yourself happier and more relaxed. You'll find yourself a hap... This is also grammatically incorrect. You will find yourself a happier and more relaxed boss, and your employees happier and more productive. Other books in this series. How to Lead a Seminar Without a Stutter. Grow a Spine, A Guide for Weak Managers. Office Romance, When Is It Okay? And How to Do Spelling and Stuff Correctly. Note, results not actually guaranteed. Fascinating. I feel like my mind has truly been put at east. Oh. Helen's encumbered. You've gone red. I should probably process these weapons. Yeah. Alright. Break it down. I just get a high capacity magazine from a pistol. Okay, much, much better. So, what did I get from that? 2 high capacity mags and a small scoop. High capacity magazine is not really important for assault rifles, they already hold 30 rounds. Yeah, if you go through a whole magazine during a fight, with an assault rifle, something's wrong. I don't know, maybe I'll get to fights that big at some point, but that has not happened yet, so I don't need the capacity for that. And that doesn't work for shotguns, right? No. And I believe I already have it on both my snipers, right? Yeah, it's on hers. And on Helen's, yes. So, in other words, the high capacity mag is basically useless. What about the small scope? Can put on pretty much anything, doesn't hurt. Who do I want to have a better chance to hit? Well, everybody. She's already got it. Let's go with Angela's weapon. There we go. One goat down, but I still got 2 goaties left.
Hey Rangers, this is Pitbull. A little birdie told me you're the asshole that let my cattle out of their pens. You fuck with my fuck slaves. I fuck with you. You get me? That's right, you whore thieves. When you least expect it.
Sounds like somebody could use some anger management. I have a booklet for that. It'll put your mind at ease. That herky-jerky movement. ...19%. And he can't move. It's not even worth shooting. I'm thinking friendly fire might be an issue here. Eh, who cares? Nice. She's so good, she shot through Theodore and Harper. Can't move anybody. God damn it. Freaking goats. Shoot the goats. Get them out of the way. I'm just kidding. I would never do that. No! You son of a bitch. You sprayed and now you're prayed. Yeah. We're near the prison. Look how clean this equipment is. It's like it's brand new. You mean this stuff? It does look rather nice. What do they got going on here? Oh, that's the Arrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrr slave labor, basically. Hearing strange noises. Might just be the animals in the farm. Man, this farm looks really pretty. Aw, look at that little detail, that's cool. Newspaper on the ground and the wind is threatening to tear it off and blow it in the wind. Blow it away. I wonder where this goes. That's the farm. Maybe the prison is actually up here and that's just the farm over here. I mean, the farm has got to be separate from the prison. Whoa. This Blackhawk is down. I was about to make a joke about that. But then I caught myself because I realized I don't actually know if that is a Blackhawk. I don't know that much about helicopters. Bomber hat. That's got to be a reference to something. My big Blackhawk. What the hell happened to you? Oh, danger. Mines. I guess he done got blewed up. Don't know if we're gonna make it through all that. I wanna come back with some reinforcements. Wait, make it through what? The mines? Looks like this scorpion wasn't so good at reading signs.
One more step, Rangers. Take just one more step. I'm begging you.
What the hell is this? It doesn't look like this robot could move even if its wiring was fixed. One of its tank treads is missing. What's going to attack us if we move? I don't see any actual mines yet. There's a toaster over there. Of course, it's impossible. Yeah, this is probably the actual entrance to the prison. Well, before going to the prison, let's go to the farm. The Arrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrr See if we can sneak a conversation with the field hand in. Get some info. How will I ever pay what I owe? Too busy to talk. Yeah, they're all slave labor. Just going through the front. Oh, wait, they're not actually enemies, are they? No, they're not. Okay, so we can just go in and talk. There's Jim Arroarder. Round-faced old fellow in a plaid shirt and denim overalls. He looks like every child's favorite grandpa. Everything this guy is wearing is awfully clean, and so are his hands. No dirt under his nails, and no calluses on his palms. You're a fake, Jim. Hiya, folks. Welcome to Arroarder Farm. I'm Jim Arroarder. Feel free to look around. The RSM said potential homesteaders will be dropping by now and then to see how good life could be in Happy Valley. Just, don't bother the field hands. They're too busy to talk. Who are the field hands? It's a sad fact that some of the local farmers around here just couldn't make a go of it. Well, I couldn't stand to see them go to rack and ruin, so I hired them to do chores around my place. Just until they can get back on their feet. Pay it forward. That's my motto. Uh-huh. Tell me about the RSM. RSM Enterprises. They're the nice folks who are turning this dusty old backwater into a thriving farming community. I couldn't have got this farm up and running without them. And what about Happy Valley? Well, it ain't exactly happy yet. I'll allow that. But it's early days yet. Things can turn around here. I'm living proof. Bye now, hope you enjoy your stay in Happy Valley. Yeah. Well, they're not enemies, so I'm not gonna start shooting up the place just yet. Maybe I can talk them into leaving or something. Whoa, what just happened? Oh, is that? Ah, there's an alarm on that thing, yeah. Hello, Job. What do you have in your hands? What is that? You can tell he was a big man once, with broad shoulders and strong hands. Now he's a scarecrow, bent and withered from hunger, with a shaggy beard framing a face made old much too soon. You got my pigeon! Finally! I've been sending them to Ranger Citadel for weeks. Are you here to kill that psycho Danforth? Can you get me back my farm? Don't know if we got your pigeon, but Sure. Why do you want Danforth dead? Did you read the note I sent? His red scorpions are taking over every farm in the prison area and making slaves out of all the people who used to own them. You have to stop them. You have to get our farms back. And listen, there's no point killing the scorpions or Farmer Jim or the foreman here at the farm. Danforth will just send more scorpions and a new boss and more foremen and kill us all. You want to kill a scorpion? You gotta cut off the head. And Danforth never comes out of the prison. So you gotta get in there and do the job right. Understand me? Okay, yeah, that's what I figured. Where is your farm? Right here. This is my farm. This is my land. These are my pigeons. The fucking Red Scorpions, or RSM Enterprises that they call themselves these days, stole it all from me. Security taxes, cow license fees, wheat allergy fund. They just kept chipping away at me until I couldn't pay anymore. Then this Farmer Jim guy came in and offered to buy it from me and bring me on as an overseer. Well, what could I do? I took the deal. I've been regretting it ever since. Tell me about the Red Scorpions. I already kind of know about them, but... Yep, now they've stolen our entire lives, and you've got to stop them. Don't worry, I will. I mean, some of these questions I kind of already know the answers to, but I just want to prod at them and see if they have anything new. You're a slave, I kind of already know that. Yes, everybody's in debt to them. They pay us in scrip, so that we can only spend it at the company stores. And everything there is so expensive that we spend all of our pay just to get enough food and water to survive. Yeah, they can never pay off their debt. What is this scrip? It's fake money. A way to make sure we don't escape. We can only spend it at the general store. It's no good anywhere else. And the exchange rates for real money is pathetic. So what's the best way to get into the prison? There is no best way. The gates are guarded by turrets that can cut a man in half in seconds. That's why we've given up hope. Nobody's ever made it to the gate. Nobody. But you're the Desert Rangers. Maybe you're tough enough, or smart enough, to beat those guns. A challenge. I like a challenge. Tell me about Farmer Jim Arrorder. I don't know who he is. Somebody said he's the brother or uncle of Commander Danforth, the leader of the Red Scorpions. Whoever he is, he doesn't have to pay any pig taxes or feed transportation tariffs. And that kindly old man act is bullshit too. He might not beat us, but he sure as hell orders the foreman to beat us. Tell me about the foreman. They're nothing but Red Scorpions with straw hats on. They'll kill you as soon as they look at you. Well, they'll kill you as soon as look at you. What have you been regretting? I kind of already know the answer to that. The price Farmer Jim paid me was just enough to clear my debt to the Scorpions, but not enough for me to leave. So I started working for him. But he pays in scrip, and never enough for me to save up. I'm a slave on my own farm. And there's no escape. Not unless you run the Scorpions out of town. I remember what the Rangers can do. What do you remember about the Rangers? I was a kid when you guys had your headquarters here, and I always loved to watch you head out on patrol. You were heroes to me then. I want you to be heroes to the whole town now, and save these people from Danforth and his Scorpions. You've got to rid the prison of them. I'll do it. I will do it. Is there anyone else here to talk to? Ooh. I see a lucrative source of shit. Do you think they'd complain and shoot me if I broke down their wall? Hopefully not. Gotta get me some shit. Oh. Let's just pretend that didn't happen. And so the story goes, the Rangers tried to save the people enslaved on the farms. But in their quest for shit, they got everybody killed. Yeah, there's nobody else to talk to. All right. Apparently nobody's ever actually made it past the turrets. I think we can. Sounds like I might want my energy weapon out, though. Takayuki says, "Into the Valley of Death, motherfuckers." Yee. I don't see any alternative entrances, so... yeah, I guess I'm just gonna go forwards.
One more step, Rangers. Take just one more step. I'm begging you. Please, cross that line of white stones, Rangers. I've been waiting all my life to see you sanctimonious butchers turned into fine red mist.
I? Who is I?
You know who this is, Rangers. I'm your worst nightmare. A wastelander who can beat you at your own game. Commander Danforth, at your service.
Glad you recognize us. Now let us in.
Sure, come ahead. I'll give you the same chance you assholes give unarmed children. Go on, take that step.
You're one of those people, huh? One of those, the Rangers shoot children and dogs people, huh?
Oh, leaving so soon?
I'm not going anywhere. Holy fuck. Okay, so they have 4,000 hit points, they have 10 armor, and they do between 200 and 300 damage. In other words, I'm not gonna blow them up. Well, I don't know what the hell you are, little thing, but I think you're the only thing here that can maybe save me. Although it does say even if the wiring was fixed, apparently one of the tank treads is missing, so I don't know if that's gonna work. Mechanical repair? Friendly Tech Tactical Systems. Mobility systems offline. Sensors have detected a missing part. Mobility systems cannot engage until missing part is replaced. Please replace part, blah blah blah. Tank tread, use only genuine for, but it doesn't say friendly. It's findly. Findly Tech. Use only genuine Findly Tech parts. Where the hell am I gonna find a tank tread part? The hell? I don't have a tank tread, do I? I'm pretty sure I would have remembered picking up a tank tread thing. Shit. I have no clue. Maybe somebody back at the Ranger Citadel will know more. I'm not stepping across that line, that's for sure. Should I write down that part number? I'm gonna write down that part number just in case it's important. Five, five, three. Okay.
Back again, Rangers? Come a little closer. I can't hear you.
Is there anything special I could type in here? Not that I can think of.
Oh, leaving so soon?
Where would I find that part? I mean, where do I even go for that? Where would I find Findly Tech parts? And it has to be a genuine one, apparently. Shit. Getting in this way, not with what we got. Nope. Is there any other way I can go? Doesn't look like it. Can't get past the Blackhawk. Huh. Well, I'll save all of you soon. Just wait a couple weeks. Maybe Red would know. He is the scrap dude, right? Let me see if this guy knows. It's the best way to get in the prison, I already asked that. I mean, it could be, you know, stored in any of these places, any of those boxes around the farm, but I have no particular reason to think it would be in any of those. And if I start nabbing from them, they're going to start shooting me. Alright, I'm going to head back to Red, and I'll be right back. Okay, here are the turrets leading up to Red's place, which I believe are still deactivated, I think. But I do want to test something. Somebody in the comments was wondering about the password. They're thinking that because the passwords are so blatantly dumb, like 12345 and preferred and stuff like that, that maybe the password is actually just password. Access code expired. Okay. So password is not the password, but apparently it actually was at one point. Alright, Red, I don't suppose you have a special part, do you? You have a tank tread on you? I don't think you're gonna have a tank tread. This is just stuff I sold you. Nope. I'm gonna keep that dud grenade. I like it. Oh, you're still poor, man. You didn't get more money between the last time I sold you stuff and now. Where the hell am I gonna find a freaking Findly Tech part? I have no idea. I don't know. I guess I'm just going back to the Citadel to go find Bejowski and hope somebody at the Citadel maybe can help me out with a part. I can't think of anything else. Alright, let's head back. I mean, who would know about a part at the Citadel? Maybe Mer-Captain? She's the one always messing around with weird doodads and stuff? Maybe. Whoa, 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 whoa. Well, if it isn't Pitbull. Okay. I see you don't want to converse. Ow. Holy shit. We're almost dead. Rest in peace, motherfucker. Ooh. He had a toy lightsaber and a singing bass on him. Oh shit, you're not doing too good. Angela. No suture, alright. This fish has a lot of bullet holes in it for some reason. Oh, I can't imagine why somebody would want to shoot such a musical, wonderful, soothing thing. This plastic contraption sounds like a blender. I feel like I might have to just, like, go around the wastes and then hope that at some point I find like an abandoned robot production facility and it's got some spare parts.
Ranger Team Echo One, this is Ranger Command. Come in. Over.
Go ahead.
10-4 Echo One. Listen, some locals up near our remote radio tower say they saw some things attacking it. Sounded like robots to me. Might be another of those synths that killed Ace. Head back there and see if you can capture it alive. But be careful. Anything that could kill Ace isn't going to be easy to deal with. Copy?
Copy.
10-4 Echo One. Ranger Command out.
Wait, so where the hell do you want me to head? Is it here? I guess it is. I mean, I can't actually look at my quests when I'm on this map. I kind of want to explore around here. Oh, wait a minute, there's a mysterious shrine down here. Did I visit that shrine? I guess I couldn't have, because it's all in darkness. Whoa. What was that? Some creepy stuff. Alright, so there's an abandoned railway station here. Looks like this woman was trying to hide, but the robots got her anyway. Wait, how do you know it was robots? Are there robots here? Oh, shit. It's a disco bot! Okay. It seems the robots have come in force now. Little Moscow Marketplace is written in bold letters at the top of the sign, above an image of bread, beets, and bullets. It's probably just the exit of the map, right? This map is actually quite large. Holy crap. Whoa, what the hell is that? It has 540 hit points. This might be too high level for me. The disco bots, I think I could take, but... Alright, let's go back here and take out the disco bots. I don't know about the slicer dicer. Jesus Christ. Killer. Yeah, I'll put you over there. I wonder what their weapons are. You think they shoot lasers or what? Armor 3. Actually, that armor is not too bad. Actually, with that armor, it might not be worth it to use the pulse rifle. Alright, what are you gonna do? You're gonna die. What is that? Octodron. That thing is really cool looking. That didn't do much, but it looked cool. Yeah, these things don't have enough armor to make that energy weapon worth it. They only have 3 armor. If they had 4, it'd be worth it. Broken barrel. I wonder if these things could have the part that I want. The tread. Wait, there's a body on the table inside of the fruit. Your stomach churns as the smell of rotting food and dead man's blood mixes in your nose. Ew. Hmm. 62%. This is actually a pretty high level place, which means there could be a trap here that I have not found. Whoa. Rubik's Cube. Neat.
Copy, Echo. Yeah, congratulations, Echo.
Skill points. I'll save those. Angela. 5 skill points. I guess I'll save those too. Or upgrade brute force. I've so rarely used brute force. It's a hard drive. I want to look at the description for that stuff. Rubik's Cube. A cube sectioned into a 3x3 grid of smaller cubes. There are fading colors on the faces. No tools, just a belt. stores massive amounts of data on its 10 megabyte hard drive. Oh boy. Okay, shall we go say hello to Slicer Dicer? Oh God. 30 to 40 damage. I'm assuming it doesn't have a burst fire. I'm hoping it doesn't have a burst fire. Well, let's get it over with. What's that thing's armor? Should I use the energy weapon? Four armor. Yeah, so the energy weapon is a good idea. Should I go up and try to stab it with a knife? That seems dumb. But that is what he does. Here we go. A Slicer Dicer is immune to bleeding. Alright, that makes sense. There's two more? There's two more back there. Holy fuck. Go for a headshot. It is a head. That's all it is. Alright, they actually might be... It looks like they might be melee, so... We might have a little bit of a reprieve here before we start getting sliced and diced. Definitely gonna burst fire everything. Okay, we might be able to do this. If we can kill it before it can get near us. Two more to go. How far can they move in a turn? Not too far, thank God. Oh, there's one over there. I did not know that. Okay, we can do this. We just need to make sure they do not actually get to us. Yeah, I should probably pulse this thing, right? Yep. Nice, that worked out pretty well. I mean, I want to move him away, but he is melee. Like, he is useless if I don't move him towards the enemy. Alright. Go ambush. Brought a knife to a... cutting wheel fight. Whoa, 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 what's it doing? Okay. It has a bit. Damn, those are really cool looking. Those are really cool looking abilities. Alright, so AoE, if you stand near it, you die. Takayuki, I have to replace you. I'm sorry. I can't have melee people. It just seems like a bad idea. I just need to clean this thing up. 24, I could easily kill that. I can't even reach that one. Alright. Let's move on closer and save Takayuki's ass. Alright, move into the AoE damage. Have fun. Slicer Dicer energy field, minus 4 coordination. This is, you're standing in a Slicer Dicer's energy field. Move. No. This is gonna hurt. Or not. No, it's actually running away. I thought it was gonna, like, smash his face. Did you actually dodge that, Takayuki? Badass. Still out of range. Whew. That ate up a lot of ammo, but that was satisfying.
Copy, Echo One. Echo One, Grant.
Harper, 6 points. Nice. Okay, kind of a crapshoot which one I want to go for. Assault rifle, lockpicking, computer science are all good. Let's make you better at let's do computer science, even though I almost never use it. Helen, gotta save your points. They didn't even drop any loot, did they? Lame. Yeah, these people stood no chance against those friggin' things. They just got sliced and diced. Don't worry, Harper. The fact that everybody is standing away from you is just... Don't worry about it. There's nothing to be nervous about. Nothing could go wrong. We just want to give you your space, you know? D20. What good's a die that comes up 20 every time? Wait, whoa, is there a person in there? Is that an enemy? They're not showing up as anything. They're alive. Hello? I can't even talk to you. What are you? Oh, I can convert you to my cause. Using computer science on Vax. Hi, my name is Vax. Human-cyborg relations. How may I be of assistance? What? Who? You want to assist me? I am programmed to imprint upon the first person who gives me orders, and that was you, sir. I am now yours to command. Okay. Does that mean you're gonna follow us like a sheep? Yay! I have a cyborg dude. What if I program him again? What happens? Oh, overclocked. Overclocked. Maximum power. What if I do it again? Oh, the power is already maximum. It's a toaster. Ah, it's impossible. Is there anything over here? Nope. Okay, that was an interesting encounter. My first real encounter with robots. Even though they had a scary amount of hit points, they weren't too bad. Although they did eat up a lot of ammo, so if I kept facing them, I would run out pretty soon. Now, the point of me coming out here was to go to the mysterious shrine, so let's do that. If the radiation isn't too bad. Are we getting hurt from radiation? Oh shit. Yeah, the radiation here is really bad. Radiation 4. I think I can only handle up to 2. This is the third time I've seen this place. Not with this thing here, but the same environment. He who knows does not speak. He who speaks does not know. Said a person whose name I probably cannot pronounce properly. I'm gonna say Lao Tzu. Silent T? I think so. We've been inspired. It looks like that was XP, because you leveled up.
Copy, Echo. Congratulations, Echo.
5 skill points. Let's do mechanical repair. Alright, we need to get the hell out of this radiated patch. Which means run! Okay. We're okay. Alright, well, this episode is already running long, so I think I better end it here. A lot of interesting things happened. So I want to save the prison, but I don't have the ability to do it at the moment. So I'm just gonna head back to... Actually, am I gonna head back to the Ranger Citadel? I was going to, but he did tell me to go check out the radio tower, which I think is this one. So maybe I actually won't go to the Ranger Citadel just yet. Because it seems there's been an outbreak, a sort of invasion of robots and or androids. So stuff is happening. Things are getting harder. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and I'll be back soon.